हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडिंग द चैप्टर अल्डिहाइड्स, कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. वी हैव फिनिश्ड विद मेथड्स ऑफ प्रेपरेशन ऑफ अल्डिहाइड्स, कीटोन्स एंड मेथड्स ऑफ प्रेपरेशन ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो लेट्स मूव अहेड. स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल बी सीइंग द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट इज टॉपिक 12.6 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके, द वेरी फर्स्ट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग इज नेचर ऑफ इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज. यू ऑल हैव लर्नड अबाउट इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज इन योर 11th स्टैंडर्ड. So you all can see your C double bond O, that is your carbonyl group in aldehydes and ketones, is a polar covalent bond. A polar covalent bond is also known as a dipole. Okay, fine. Polar covalent bond means it has partial charges on it. All right, fine. Now the compounds which have polar covalent bond are known as polar covalent molecules. So these compounds, they contain dipole-dipole forces of attraction between them. Alright, dipole-dipole forces of attraction is one type of intermolecular force. So your aldehydes and ketones, because they have carbonyl group, they'll have dipole-dipole forces of attraction between them. So your dipole-dipole forces are nothing but electrostatic interactions between dipoles on neighboring molecules. Okay, fine. Like electrostatic force of attraction. So if you all see the diagram over here. Okay, you all can see this is one carbonyl group, this is another carbonyl group, C double bond O, C double bond O. So the oxygen has partial negative charge, carbon has partial positive charge. Okay, now suppose assume these to be two different compounds. Okay, so they are having dipole-dipole attraction between them. Now if you all see the molecules, they orient in such a way so that the oppositely charged atoms or the oppositely polarized atom will face each other. Okay, so you can see both are carbonyl groups, but over here, because of the electrostatic forces of attraction, the partial negative charge is facing the partial positive. Over here, the partial positive is facing the partial negative. So these are the type of intermolecular forces in aldehydes, ketones. Next, we'll see the type of intermolecular forces in carboxylic acid. So the C double bond OH, which is the carboxyl group of carboxylic acid. Alright, you all can see this is little different because it has an OH in it. So the OH is responsible for hydrogen bonding. Again, hydrogen bonding is one type of intermolecular force. So hydrogen bonding is a type of a dipole-dipole attraction, like it is kind of same. Over here, what happens, a hydrogen atom, it is bonded to a strongly electronegative atom, okay, or an atom which has lone pair of electrons. Alright, hydrogen atom, when it bonds to a strongly electronegative atom, that is nothing but hydrogen bonding. So you all can see here, there's an example. I've drawn a structure over here. You all can see, what is this figure? This figure is nothing but dimer of acetic acid. If you all carefully observe, you all can see CH3 C double bond O OH. So this is like one acetic acid, and this is the other one, CH3 C double bond O, and then there is OH. So between both these acetic acid molecules, see, the two molecules are held together by two hydrogen bonds. You all can see the hydrogen bonding over here. Okay, so the hydrogen of the OH of this molecule bonds with this oxygen of the other molecule. Okay, similarly the hydrogen of the other molecule bonds with the oxygen of this molecule. Okay, I have also drawn the partial charges. Fine. So in carboxylic acid, the OH is responsible for formation of hydrogen bonding. Okay, so now out of the three compounds, because of the hydrogen bonding factor, we can claim that carboxylic acids have strongest intermolecular forces of attraction. Okay, fine. So in aldehydes, ketones, there is dipole-dipole forces of attraction, and carboxylic acid, there is hydrogen bonding. Okay. The second physical property that we are going to see is physical state and boiling point of aldehydes and ketones. So here we are just discussing the physical states and boiling point of aldehydes, ketones. Okay. These are the few compounds that have been discussed in your textbook. For example, let us take formaldehyde, which is the very first aldehyde. So formaldehyde is gaseous at room temperature and it has an irritating odor. Alright. Let's discuss another type of aldehyde, that is acetaldehyde. So acetaldehyde is a colorless liquid and it is extremely volatile in nature. Volatile means it evaporates easily. higher aldehydes have pleasant odor. All right, if you see formaldehyde, the very first one has an irritating odor, but from acetaldehyde onwards, that is higher aldehydes means the aldehydes which have more number of carbon atoms. Okay, so they'll have a pleasant odor. All right, next is acetone, which is the first member of the ketone family. So acetone is liquid at room temperature and it has a pleasant odor. All right, so acetone has a pleasant odor, but if you see over here, most higher ketones have bland odor. Okay, so the higher ketones, that is as soon as the number of carbon atoms increases in ketone, the odor is not good. All right, fine. So this was about the physical state. Students, for the physical properties, I have taken the points from the textbook only. So I have seen to it that I explain it in like short manner and everything is covered. So y'all can note these points down. All right. So we discussed the physical state. Next we'll see the boiling point. Okay, so the boiling point. So for that I would like to show table 12.4 of your textbook. So if you all can see the table, boiling point of aldehydes and ketones. So there are number of carbon atoms, there's aldehyde and its boiling point, ketone and its boiling point. One carbon aldehyde is nothing but methanol, your methanol is nothing but formaldehyde. Two carbon is ethanol, which is acetaldehyde, and then so on. Okay, so if you all observe, if you all see, the boiling point that is there, it is going on increasing. Okay, like see, it starts from 252 Kelvin and it is going till 392 Kelvin. So the boiling point is increasing as the number of carbon atom increases. Let's have a look at ketones. Obviously we don't have 1 and 2 carbon ketones. The very first member is acetone, which is nothing but propanone, which is a 3 carbon compound, and its boiling point starts from 329 Kelvin and it goes up till 400. So even for ketones, as the number of carbon atom increases, the boiling point is increasing. Okay, the next physical property that we'll discuss is solubility of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, so if you all see the first point over here, the C double bond O carbonyl group involves in hydrogen bonding with water molecule. Okay, we are checking solubilities of aldehydes and ketones. If you all observe this diagram carefully, you all can see the carbonyl group C double bond O with partial positive, partial negative charge. HOH is nothing but a water molecule where the oxygen atom has partial negative charge and hydrogen has partial positive, and there's a hydrogen bond that is formed. So C double bond O involves in hydrogen bonding with the water molecule. Okay, so because of this hydrogen bonding point, we can claim that the lower aldehydes and ketones are water soluble. Lower aldehydes and ketones meaning aldehydes and ketones which are less number of carbon atoms. Now what is the relationship is that solubility decreases as molecular mass increases. Okay, fine. So it means that as you all will move to higher aldehydes and ketones, that is as the number of alkyl groups increases in aldehydes and ketones, the solubility decreases. Because why is this happening? As the hydrocarbon part increases, they cannot form hydrogen bond. See, we just saw that carbonyl group forms hydrogen bonding. Now this is helpful for the solubility part, and that is the reason the lower aldehydes and ketones are soluble in water. But as soon as you move to higher aldehydes and ketones, the number of alkyl group goes on increasing and formation of the C double bond O, formation of the hydrogen bond becomes more difficult. Okay, fine. See, as the hydrocarbon part increases, they cannot form hydrogen bond. All right, so we discussed physical state, boiling point and solubility of aldehydes, ketones. Now in the fourth point, let's see physical state, boiling point and solubilities of carboxylic acid. Okay, so first let us discuss the physical state. Now our lower aliphatic carboxylic acid, okay, please make a note, aliphatic carboxylic acid. All right, by lower they mean up to 9 carbon atoms. So carboxylic acids up to 9 carbon atoms, how is their physical state? They are colorless liquids and they have an irritating odor. Okay, fine. The higher homolukes, okay, now the homolukes word is nothing but this was discussed in your 11th standard. Homolukes are nothing but compounds that belong to the same family. Now here we are discussing about the carboxylic acid family, right? So फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई स्टार्ट विद फॉर्मिक एसिड, नेक्स्ट इज एसिटिक एसिड, नेक्स्ट इज प्रोपेनोइक एसिड. सो इफ यू ऑल कैन सी द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन आइटम इज गोइंग ऑन इंक्रीजिंग वन बाय वन. सो दे बिलोंग टू द सेम फैमिली ऑल राइट, बट द इंडिविजुअल मेंबर इज नोन एज होमोल्यूक. सो हायर होमोल्यूक्स मीन्स द हायर एलिफैटिक कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो हाउ इज दे आर फिजिकल स्टेट, दे आर कलरलेस इन नेचर, दे आर ओडरलेस, दे आर वैक्स लाइक सॉलिड्स एंड दे हैव लो वोलेटिलिटी. ओके फाइन. नेक्स्ट वील डिस्कस द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. फॉर दिस यू हैव टू रिफर टेबल 12.5. आई विल जस्ट शो इट टू यॉल. यू ऑल कैन सी दिस टेबल. ओके सो फॉर्मिक एसिड, द वेरी फर्स्ट कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, इट्स बॉइलिंग पॉइंट इज 373 केल्विन एंड एज द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन आइटम्स इज इंक्रीजिंग द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग. ओके नाउ वन थिंग टू मेक अ नोट ऑफ इज कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड हैव हाइएस्ट बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. ओके लाइक द एसिड कंपाउंड्स दे हैव मच हायर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट्स देन द अदर कंपाउंड्स दैट यू ऑल हैव स्टडीड टिल नाउ. सो देयर इज अ टेबल फॉर दैट एज वेल. यू कैन सी द टेबल 12.6, वेरिएशन ऑफ बॉइलिंग पॉइंट विद फंक्शनल ग्रुप. सी द फर्स्ट कंपाउंड इज अल्केन, देन ईथर, अल्डिहाइड, कीटोन, अल्कोहल एंड लास्ट कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सी देयर बॉइलिंग पॉइंट फॉर अल्केन इट इज 272, इट गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड दे हैव टेकन सर्टन एग्जाम्पल्स. ओके सो हियर दे हैव टेकन एसिटिक एसिड, फॉर एसिटिक एसिड इट इज 391 केल्विन. ओके सो यू ऑल कैन सी स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज इज इंक्रीजिंग. जस्ट नाउ व्हेन वी वर डिस्कसिंग इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज वी सॉ दैट कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड हैव हाई इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज एज कम्पेयर टू अल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स. ओके फाइन. सो एज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ इंटरमोलिक्युलर फोर्सेज इज इंक्रीजिंग ऑब्वियसली द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. ओके सो हियर आर सर्टन पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सी In liquid, they form dimer in which two molecules are held by two hydrogen bonds. This dimer part we just discussed, okay? This structure that we discussed, okay? See, dimer of acetic acid, this is one example. So, two acid molecules held together by hydrogen bonds, all right? Now, because of intermolecular hydrogen bonding, okay, you all can see there is intermolecular hydrogen bonding between two molecules, okay? Therefore, it has high boiling point. Like the point is to discuss why carboxylic acid is having highest boiling point. Alright. So firstly the point is it is forming hydrogen bonding. Okay. It forms dimer. And intermolecular hydrogen bonding indicates that the boiling point is high. Now due to the presence of hydrogen bonds, more energy is required to break the bonds. Okay. Like we saw in that table, increasing intermolecular forces means the boiling point also increases. Okay. Fine. Here you all can make a note of one thing, that acetic acid dimers exist even in the gas phase. Okay, like for acetic acid, the dimer, that is this structure, okay, this dimer structure, it exists in gaseous phase as well, whereas for the other acids it has to be in liquid phase. Okay, fine. Next we'll discuss about the solubility of carboxylic acid. So here are certain points. You see lower aliphatic carboxylic acid. Now here by lower they mean up to 4 carbon atoms. Okay. So up to 4 carbon atoms, whatever aliphatic carboxylic acids are there, they are miscible in water. Okay. They are soluble in water. That is because they form hydrogen bonds. Okay. See the next point, solubility in water decreases with increase in molecular mass. If you all see, this point is exactly similar like solubility of aldehydes and ketones. Okay, for lower aldehydes and ketones, they are soluble, but as soon as the number of carbon atoms goes on increasing, formation of hydrogen bonding becomes difficult. Okay, like hydrogen bonding doesn't happen, therefore they are not soluble. So same is the case with carboxylic acids as well. Okay, fine. So as solubility in water will decrease with increase in molecular mass, that is with increasing number of carbon atoms. Okay, this is about aliphatic carboxylic acid. Now what about aromatic acids? Aromatic acids are also practically insoluble in water at room temperature. So I can make a note. See, lower aliphatic carbons, up to 4 carbons, they are soluble. Above that, they are insoluble. And aromatic acids are also insoluble. Okay. So students, for that you all can make a note of one thing, that water insoluble carboxylic acids, all the acids that are insoluble in water, they are soluble in less polar organic solvents like ether, alcohol, benzene and so on. Okay, so if they are not soluble in water, they might be soluble in some other polar organic solvents, for example ethers, alcohols, benzene and so on. Okay, so with this we are done with the physical properties part. Next rest we'll continue in the next lecture. Thank you.